I love ECS, the beauty of its simple definition and the different kind of mindset I get from it. But sometimes, the simple definition just isn't enough. What I struggle with most in my ECS implementation are the systems. The entities and components are quite clear, but the systems for some reason just confused me. The reason for it was that I believed that systems must both get the data and process it at the same time. Then, as I got to more complex use cases, it got to the point where I just couldn't figure it out. Then, while thinking about how to cache systems so they don't have to request components each frame they run, it occurred to me that that's not what systems are for at all. And it was exactly this point that made me realize that the concepts don't have to be connected. We don't have to get the data and immediately process it in one step. And most importantly, we don't have to get the data each frame. This made me realize that what I'm looking for can't just simply be nicely wrapped up into a simple ECS definition. It's too open for interpretation. Or maybe if I were to give it a nice little name for it, I'd call it something like ECQS for entities, components, queries, and systems. This way, when I treat queries as its own thing, we can start having fun with defining how queries work and look. I've seen a lot of processing entities and components linearly, using for each and going one by one, so I have a linear query that keeps entities and references to them linearly, and we can simply cache it and rebuild it when needed. But also, we don't have to. Other example is hierarchical query, a tree of entities and their components, and their children. This can be traversed from parent to child, adding so much flexibility. I started building simple little processing functions around this concept. Once we build the query, we usually just need a few things, iterating over all the items in some way and allowing us to process them. Most of the processing functions have the same general structure. We need a query to work with and a function that does something with each of the items. With these, we create simple repeated patterns that can be extended freely. Systems don't need to be heavy. They can just request a query or more queries. These are cached outside of the system's influence, and the system just transforms the data using the processing functions. Now we're more free. I can define more queries or more processing functions, or even custom processing functions within a single system. Like for hierarchical query, I made a function that propagates a value from parent to children during the processing. This is useful in my UI system, or will be useful when we deal with hierarchical transforms and things like that. We don't really care anymore if the system runs each frame, or just in response to an event. The systems are cheap and lightweight. The ones that run each frame all live in different system stores based on when we want to run them. For example, logic system store might even run at a different frame rate than vendor system store. These are simple function stores. I haven't yet decided on some concrete solid way to swap systems in and out. This is an important part because we don't want to run all the systems all the time. Imagine we're making a space game. We want to run different systems depending on if the player is controlling their character or if they're flying the spaceship. That's why I went with the store solution. I want to have some way to manage what systems run when, maybe even have a bundle system allow requesting what systems it needs to run. So when we spawn in a bundle, it tells us what systems the entities within the bundle needs. But right now, it's just a simple vector of functions that runs one after another when we're in a specific point in the game loop. I'm currently very happy with it. The whole querying system is probably one of the most complicated things I've designed on this project, and I'm glad to see that it works. Basically everything you see uses it, so it's important for me to get this right. But also, there's a lot of work ahead with this system, making it nicer to use, maybe even going back to the idea of putting it all into one function. Now that all the parts work together so well, and I know how they work, we could make it so that the system just says, let's iterate over a query that looks like this, and the query gets built, cached, and processed all at once. Now that I'm thinking about it, it's much more possible than it was at the beginning. And that's the beauty of all this. At first, something seems weird and impossible, but going into a different direction might bring me back to the original idea, but now with more knowledge, it sounds possible. If you enjoyed this a bit more abstract architectural talk, like and subscribe. Comment what you think about all this. I'm always so happy to discuss implementation with all of you in the comments. And be prepared for the next video, the challenges of implementing the first bits of gameplay within my game engine. Thank you, goodbye.